vacuum tubes. These are in the 74 oh something. I forgot what they are. I should look in the back, but they're hot and I can't touch them right now. All I know is that this is rated at 11 watts total power. And it's a single-ended amp. It only has one output tube. And we're going to older Klipschorns. This one has a Electro-Voice 12-inch speaker from the 1960s. And it's a Klipschorn. That one, I'm not even sure what model is. So if you know what model of Klipschorn this is, please let me know, because I haven't really found it in any documentation. I believe it's probably from around 1962 or so, and it's a corner Klipschorn. This is actually a really ugly short horn cabinet with no nice woodwork on it at all. It was probably used in a theater or something. It has a Electro-Voice 15B RSO series speaker that actually is used in bass guitar amps for bass guitar and for sound reinforcement in concerts. But it's extremely sensitive. It only requires very little SPL or very little wattage to make a high SPL level. And we have Fenola tweeters in it this time. They're actually Sirwin Vega Fenola tweeters that go up to 20,000 cycles. So we're going to hear a little bit to avoid copyright infringement. We're just going to play a few bars from Stick It by Buddy Rich. And this is called God Bless the Child. The turntable is going directly into the tube amp. The tube amp is going direct, or the turntable is plugged right in to the tube amps. So you're going right from the turntable into the tube amp. And there's no preamplifier or anything other than the one that's in the Audio Technica. So you could say it's going through some transistors, but the output is purely vacuum tube. I believe that this dates from about 1966 or 67, somewhere in there. It is the amplifier from a reel-to-reel. And so that's what we just heard.